Hey, it's John at Enduring Charm. So I'm going to talk to you today about air conditioning condensate pumps. And not all systems have this. I'll explain that shortly. But if you have a air conditioning system that lives in your basement, odds are you probably have something that looks very much like this. And we'll explain there is a little bit of maintenance you want to think about over the years with this, but otherwise they're mostly trouble-free. All right, just a real quick overview of how air conditioning and refrigeration units work. And this is oversimplified, but just to give you an idea. So there's a few components. It's a closed system. So you have an evaporator, which is located inside in your house, and then we'll talk about that in a second. You have a compressor, which is basically a pump, and that compresses the refrigerant, the freon, in the system. And then that compressed refrigerant comes to a condenser under high pressure. And the act of changing the pressure of the refrigerant allows the system to either give up heat, in the case of the condenser that's located outdoors, or in the evaporator you have air passing over the fins and it cools the air passing over those fins. All right, that's greatly oversimplified, I know, but I just want to give you an idea of what the components are they're going to be talking about. So here on this system, you have a heating unit, okay, which is located right on the floor here, and this is in a basement. And then on top of that heating unit is the evaporator. And you can see some of the lines running in, the cooling lines running in here, okay? And so the way the system works is it takes the fan that is used for the heating and also uses it for the air conditioning as well. So that fan is located down here on the bottom. It's blowing, forcing hot air through the system here. And in here are cooling fins in the evaporator. And as that air goes over those fins, it cools down. Now, as that air is cooling down, condensation occurs as well. In a house, there's humidity, and that condensation has to go somewhere. So you'll see on all of these systems some kind of pipe coming out the bottom. So there's basically a tray that's collecting any moisture or water that drops off of the evaporator, comes down here, and is collected in a pipe. Now, depending where this is located, this pipe is going to lead to two different places. One, if it's located in an attic or near ground level perhaps, this pipe is just going to lead gravity, towards gravity, and it just drips out, and you'll notice drippage somewhere. Sometimes it's located on a roof, sometimes it's located on the ground or whatever, but if gravity it can be used, this will just drip out, and any water, condensate, just drips out. But if it's located below ground in a basement, which is, the case in a lot of these systems, the pipe is going to come out and go to a condensate system. And this is literally just, it's basically just like a little sump pump. That's all it is. We're going to show you some of this in a second. But in that bottom black plastic area there is just a reservoir. And when it gets deep enough, the water gets deep enough, a little pump comes on and pumps that water out. So, and there's actually a surprising amount of water that comes out of these systems. When that is pumped out, it's just going to go to a small tube, and it's going to be sent outdoors. Now let me go show you where that goes. All right, here outdoors is the condenser, and the compressor is inside here. Now I have a different video showing how to clean these things, and you might want to take a look at that too. But what we're here to talk about is that condensate, where that comes out. Very often you'll see the pipe comes out, let me get back down in here, right by the condenser, let me get in here. And it's just going to be a small little pipe like this. It might be, this one's copper. You might see it made of vinyl or some kind of tubing. But it's just going to be a small pipe like this. And this brings me to the first maintenance tip I want to talk about. Like I said, there's a surprising amount of water that comes out of these, especially if you live in a humid area. And one thing I often see is that this tube gets buried in vegetation, or it's just located in a spot that's right next to the foundation, and that water that's coming out of here will end up going, into places it probably shouldn't. It can, I've seen holes get dug into right next to the foundation just from the volume of water coming out here. It also comes out fairly quickly because it's being pumped. So the first tip I want to mention is that You may want to extend this tube, and you can take vinyl tubing and add it to the end of this and extend it to a place where gravity takes it away from the house. You don't want this buried, you know, in the dirt, buried right next to the foundation, that kind of thing. Now, having said that, it is a pump on the other end of this, and there's a column of water it has to push out. So depending on the vertical rise, you have to be careful not to add too much on the end of this. If it's a horizontal run, it's not a problem. But if you're adding tubing so that it's going up, or that pump is forced to push a column of water further than it can handle, that could be a problem. But generally speaking, you can add, you know, a few feet to this if you want with a vinyl tube or something like that. Just push it on the end here and, you know, send that water to somewhere more safe. So that's tip number one. All right, tip number two is the pump itself. Now, generally speaking, these are maintenance free. You don't generally have to do too much with them. They're not particularly expensive. They're about $50 to buy if you needed a new one, and most of them look very similar to this. However, you know, sometimes over time, the reservoir can get gunk in them, and it can clog up the pump or can clog up the tube itself. I'm sorry, my light is limited here. And you can take this little piece of plastic off. Most of them have something similar, and look down on in there. In fact, this one, yeah, as I look in there, it's there. So I look on in there, it's got some gunk in there. So it may be a good idea, if you have time, to clean this out, take it apart, clean it out, and just get some of the gunk out, and you'll get longer life out of it. Now, if you decide you want to clean it or take a harder look at it, first thing you want to do is turn the system off. So you're going to have some kind of switch like this. It might be right near the HVAC system, or it might be, you know, located on the top of the basement stairs, something like that. But you're going to flip that off. That'll cut power to the whole system. You also have a plug usually for the pump itself. However, you don't want the system running without the pump, because you're going to get water everywhere. And that kind of leads to one of my next tips, which is if you see water on the ground of your HVAC system, it's probably the condensate pump. Either the pump itself has failed, if you have a pump, or, you know, there's a clog or a problem in the tray where the condensate is collected. So you have to take a look to see where the water's coming from. But if you see water on the ground, that's not normal and something's gone wrong. So if it is the pump, you need to replace it. Like I said, you'll just disconnect the power here. And then to disassemble this thing, it's not terribly hard. I'll try to get a light here. So you got some bolts here. Let me get a little lower. Some bolt, you know, bolts here that are bolted to the side. It may be located in a different spot. It could be on the floor. It could be located all sorts of different places. But there's basically, you know, a couple bolts there. And you can remove this whole thing. There is, I'm trying to get a camera in here. So this tube needs to be disconnected. This is just vinyl tubing. You can buy it anywhere. And, you know, depending on how this is set up, you might need to loosen some other clamps and stuff just to get the whole unit loose. But it's not rocket science. So I'm going to take this one off and apart here, and we'll take a look inside. All right, so here's the pump off. And to remove it, all I had to do was, this is the tube leading out from the pump. And actually, this is kind of getting hard. So what I might replace this just because it's no longer flexible. So it may start to leak on me. So that's the tube leading out. This was the tube leading in. It just sits into that hole. So that, I'm sorry, that tube leading in just goes into this hole. Just, you know, fits in there. And basically this is a self-contained unit. Now I'm going to bring this outdoors where I can clean it out a little bit, and we'll take another look. All right, so now that we're outdoors, this is enough to gross you out. This is what's in the reservoir. And I mean, I don't even know what, I mean, it's just solids in there, right? It's gross. And then the pump pump itself here. So you got up here is the motor up top, and then down here is the inlet for the pump. And this is just a float, just like you'd have in a sump pump system. It's literally the same idea. Some systems have an emergency shutoff so that it signals the air conditioning system if the pump is not, you know, if it's malfunctioning, something went wrong. And some do not have that, but either way, it works the same idea. So you have an inlet here for the pump, the float, and when the water gets too high, the float comes on, you know, comes on, signals the motor to run, and it just pumps it out. So the point is, with all this gunk in here, it can actually clog up the inlet and become a problem and start to leak. So all this is so nasty. All I'm going to do is clean this out. I'll dump this water out and just use a hose to clean it out. And then I'll use a hose to clean this out as well. You could do it in a sink, I guess, too. You can spray it with a very light bleach, like Clorox cleanup or something like that. But don't go too crazy with that, just to keep the mold and that kind of stuff down. So we'll clean this out and put it back together. All right, that's a little better all cleaned out. So, it's not perfect, doesn't matter. You just want to get most of the solids out. And if there's any heavy mold or something like that, you want to take care of that. You're not going to get all of it, but that's fine. Make sure if you use soap or bleach or something like that, that you clean all of that off first, because you don't want it getting soapy in there and clogging up the pump or anything like that. So to put this back together, you just one-handed, put this right back on top. It clicks in. And just to show you this again, so this is the tube where the water is pumped out. You want to make sure that's clear. There's no solids or anything stuck in there. And these are just access ports for the condensate pipe. In my case, here I got a plug and another plug, and that's where the condensate goes in. So very simple thing, but I keep telling people it's so important to keep your HVAC system clean, whether it's air conditioning or heating. Just cleaning it and keeping on top of the little things like this makes a big difference as far as longevity. Now, I showed you that had that vinyl tube that connects here, and what I'll do is either replace the tube or at least cut off the end, because that got stretched out and it's hardened now from time, and I don't want a leak to form there. So just pay attention to that. All right, that's the system back together now. Make sure you turn the power back on and plugged in. Make sure you got a good connection. I cut the end off of this vinyl tubing and put it back on the connector there. I forgot to mention earlier, there is a loop in this system put there on purpose. It's kind of like a P-trap under a sink, same idea. And you should be ready to go. Now, as far as testing this, you got to have the system back on, and it'll take a little while for this reservoir to fill up, but once it fills up, you should see that float kick on and the pump will come on and pump it out, so you can watch that. Now, if you do see a leak, it could be the pump, and look for water under the pump or in this area. If you do see a leak elsewhere, though, like coming from up top here or under the furnace itself, then it's probably the pan that's supposed to collect the condensate. And some of the pans were made of metal and they just rust through. Others or newer ones are probably plastic, but that can be an issue as well. And there could be a clog in this as well. You know, this can get solids in it. So that's another whole story as far as cleaning that out. But if you take the time every so often, maybe, you know, every 4 or 5 years to clean out this pump, it'll easily last the life of the system. And then just make sure, as I said, that the tube where it comes out outdoors is in a place that's not causing damage as well. And just some of these little things like this go a long way as far as making the system last longer.